Luxembourg.
This is your friendly station, great to away, the ringing, swinging station of the stars.
In the days before rock and roll,
in the days.
On my knees at the wireless knob.
Kiss by kiss we'll go up to paradise. Darling, don't you know heaven only lies in the reach of those who dare to climb up the stairway of love.
Why don't you make a date with 208, your friendly station, and the day of
Radio Luxembourg is to stop broadcasting to Britain on medium wave after 58 years. It was the first pop station to be heard here, but recently it's been hit by falling advertising revenue and lower audience figures.
In the 1930s, advertisers like Ovaltine discovered on Radio Luxembourg the power of commercial broadcasting. With an audience double that of the staid BBC, Luxembourg brought light and warmth into drab pre-war Britain. After the war, Luxembourg attracted audiences of up to 9 million with its sponsored entertainment shows.
It's Woodbine quiz time! And here's the compere of our show, David Jacobs.
I introduced the most disgraceful program, which I think was called Lucky Couple. We married them round the corner in the registry office and rushed them to the studio, put them on the stage with lots of people, guests of their own invitation, sitting in the audience, and we totally embarrassed them by asking them all sorts of ridiculous questions about themselves. And it was probably in the time when couples hadn't actually been to bed together before they got married. So it was a bit cheeky. And it was presented by Fife's Bananas. And the great thing was that every time I said, 1, 2, 3, 4, the audience had to shout out, Fife's Bananas. So it was 1, 2, 3, 4, Fife's Bananas, and we threw bananas at the audience. Now that was a classical show.
Today, fewer than 400,000 people a week make a date with Luxembourg. In the future, it'll only be available to people with satellite television.
Our last report tonight comes from, I will endeavour to find it, it comes from this proud and independent little country. Its position between Germany and France and the Low Countries puts it at a sort of European crossroads.
When I was a kid at school, I did not have any idea that Luxembourg was a little country. It wasn't until much, much later. Much later. I mean, I think I was probably... I probably already started making records when I suddenly realised that Luxembourg is not just a radio station, it's not just like tuning into the local station. It's a place. I didn't realise it was a place as such. I just thought it was a couple of rooms with DJs in it.
This
is Radio Luxembourg, your station of the stars, broadcasting on 208 meters medium wave. It's time for Top 20. Hi, everybody. This is your DJBA, Barry Aldis, at the microphone. It's great to be with you again. Yes, here we go with all that's best in the world of wax. Pops aplenty in Top 20. And number one on the list, well, they've made it, those sensational Supremes with Baby Love.
Record fans, wherever you are. Once again, it's time for another roundup of all your favorite British and American recording artists, brought to you by the Decca Record Company for your special delight tonight. Oh, excuse me, madam.
Yes?
I work for Luxembourg, you see.
Oh, I am sorry. I'm afraid I can't help you.
No. I was hoping you'd play chaperone to this young fella.
Whoa. Hey now, this is Britain's longest serving, solid sounding, super duper smile station. The station that spouts a successful sound soonest. And this is your royal ruler. I wouldn't fool you. Nothing could be cooler. This is Tony Prince. Hi, kids.
The station closing, it is a very historic occasion. Because you know something very special is over. It's meant so much to me personally, but it started long before I worked for it. I mean, it was what we used to listen to at night when you were a kid. The family would gather around the mains receiver and Dad would try and get rid of that.
We are the Oval Genius.
And we'd put up with all that noisy static. Because there was nowhere else to go for your musical entertainment in those days. So I remember very distinctly a big coal fire in a Northern England home on Sunday night listening to the chart show, the Top 20, and, Jimmy Savaltine and 20 Disc Club, Sam Costa, people, DCCA, Decca, Decca, and those awful programs where they only played a minute of each record. I mean, little did we know that was a commercial reason. Rather than jamming as many pieces of music into an hour as possible, it was because the record company paid for the hour and they wanted to plug all the records they could, you know. We didn't realize that in those days. In fact, I think Luxembourg was taking legal payola long before there was any scandal or even the word payola meant anything. You know, they were actually taking money for playing records. And there was nothing wrong with it in those days, or it didn't seem so.
When I first heard this fantastic radio program, Radio Luxembourg, it was absolutely unbelievable being a kid, because we was only used to the very stuffy, stagey BBC with its Mantovani, and the nearest you ever got to rock and roll was Billy Cotton and his band show. It was absolutely the music for the teenagers, and the kids would say Fabulous Radio Luxembourg. That's what it was abbreviated to Fab. But the beat boom wouldn't have happened without the help of Luxembourg. And when I first got into rock and roll and being a singer, when I heard that, it's because of Luxembourg I became a singer. So Luxembourg's to blame for those terrible records I've made.
Ready, Dave?
Wait, you